Guru Maharaj gave us heavy duty for maintaining his Chaitanya Sarvata Math deities and devotees. And we are trying heart and soul to maintain his mission and fulfill his desire. This is only duty for us. Not only myself alone, everybody will try to fulfill his desire. Guru Maharaj was very great. He had very great personality, and nobody can compete with his personality. And Sripad Swami Maharaj and Guru Maharaj, all over the world, they are preaching Krishna consciousness. We always remember Srila Swami Maharaj. Swami Maharaj and Guru Maharaj's friendship was very intimate. You read the books. Some books, what's the name?
Guardian of Devotion.
Guardian of Devotion, printed from San Jose Temple. And I also read from there. And I know Swami Maharaj from my childhood. When I joined in this Krishna Consciousness Mission of Srila Guru Maharaj, that time was 1947. And from 1947, after 2-3 months, I went to Calcutta, a mot of Guru Maharaj. That mot was in the house of Srila Swami Maharaj. Swami Maharaj was that time Giriyastha. And he had two houses, one three-storied building, one two-storied building. And he spent one for Guru Maharaj. Under first floor, ground floor, there was his laboratory, Himalton Laboratory's name was there. And upstairs, four rooms are there, two rooms using Guru Maharaj in the roadside. At two rooms we are using. From that time, I am associated with Sripad Swami Maharaj also. And 10 or 12 years I was in charge of Calcutta Mott. 7th Sitakanta Banerjee Lane. Then, from that time I have seen and I inspired. Also Guru Maharaj inspired by Swami Maharaj to preach. After Gauri mission leaving, Srila Guru Maharaj do not want to preach. Wants to do some bhajan and writing and staying alone. He liked very much. But Swami Maharaj given him inspiration. Sometimes I have seen, he go and preach, go and preach. And he is taking. But Guru Maharaj is not going. Times may gone. But Swami Maharaj is not hopeless. And he was very enthusiastic, and he taking us. Especially myself was there in Sitakanta Banerjee Lane, and he is arranging in Calcutta town, east, west, north side, and south Calcutta also, arranging some meeting and taking us 3-4 brahmachari was there, and I was red cloth, saffron cloth, Gaurendu Brahmachari, my name was Gaurendu Brahmachari, and Swami Maharaj giving me a position of Dasasana, and he is preaching, but showing Indian style, it is saffron cloth, we got some position. This way, Swami Maharaj showing me, preaching himself. I am only reading the Srimad Bhagavatam slokas or Srimad Bhagavad-gita slokas, and Swami Maharaj explaining everything, giving explanation. This way, very small scale, Swami Maharaj preaching that time. And I have seen when Swami Maharaj is getting some money, little money, and he is trying to publish one magazine, and that magazine is back to Godhead. Now he is that magazine all over the world spread. And that time maybe 250 or 400 copies he is printing. And we are distributing that in shop to shop. Dallas Square, Esplanade, Bada Bazaar, going only 25 paise value was the value. This way, Swami Maharaj was very enthusiastic to preach and sometimes wants to take Guru Maharaj big see the big man. Also Gandhi, you heard the name Mahatma Gandhi? He called by Indian father of nation. And Swami Maharaj is always cooperating with negotiating with Gandhi, Jawaharlal by letter.
Correspondence.
And that letter also, few with maybe Sudhir Goswami. He is a very expert man. He collected everything. A few letters also with Sudhir Goswami, he said. And writing to everybody, big man, Dr. Radhakrishnan, he was president of India. And when his business was in Allahabad, birthplace of Jawaharlal Nehru, maybe, father's house, Jawaharlal Nehru, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, he was the first Prime Minister of India, and also big personality, but they was friend of Swami Maharaj. He had one big medicine shop in Allahabad. Most big medicine shop, first in Allahabad. Then everybody coming to his shop, and this way, friendship with everybody, big man. And also preaching, always preaching tendency we have seen. In the time of Srila Prabhupada, Srila Guru Maharaj preached in South India. First preaching place, South India. After taking Diksha Mantram from Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur, he went for discovery of Ramananda Rai and Mahaprabhu's Milan Khetra.
The place of their discussion.
Yes, discussion. Sent by his Gurudev, Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur, in the town of Bank of Godavari, there Kubbur, and Rajamahendri. Other side, Rajamahendri of Godavari River, and Kubbur other side. And in Kubbur, there, some place we have seen, the meeting place of Mahaprabhu. And Prabhupada Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur sent Guru Maharaj there for discover that place. And Guru Maharaj went there and meditating and discovered that place, searching after verification where it is possible. And Prabhupada himself gone there and opened the temple. And that temple also make Guru Maharaj. And after that, Guru Maharaj sent it by Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur to Madras, Bombay. It's a many big town. At that time, one office was Sai Maharaj's office in Bombay. And when Sai Maharaj and Guru Maharaj, 1930, meted in Allahabad, and after that Guru Maharaj brought Swami Maharaj to Prabhupada Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur, and looking Srila Saraswati Thakur, Sai Maharaj was very happy and remarked in Bengali, "Ja atodine Mahaprabhu kathata ekjon manusher moto manusher hate poreche." This remark, the first remark Sai Maharaj done, "Ja after so long days, now one man preaching really conception of Srila Mahaprabhu, Sriman Mahaprabhu." This was his first remark about Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur. After so long, Rup, Sanatan, Jeev, Raghunath, and Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami, Nartan Thakur, and some long gap. After that, long gap. Baladev Vishnubhushan, and gap in very long time. And Mahaprabhu's religion, preaching, conception was very high, but few of sampradaya, that is called apo sampradaya. What English apo sampradaya?
Sahujya.
No. English word. Apo sampradaya.
Sahajya is imitation.
Imitation. Imitating. Few of Bengali and other countries also imitating Mahaprabhu's preaching conception. That way it was very bad situation to preach the Vaishnavism, real Vaishnavism. But when Bhakti Vinod Thakur, Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur, father of Srila Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur, appeared, and as a associate of Srimad Mahaprabhu, close devotee of Srimad Mahaprabhu, he tried to preach the Krishna consciousness, real Krishna consciousness, what gave us Srimad Mahaprabhu. Then 13 apo sampradaya called imitationist. They was very angry with Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Srila Prabhupada Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur. And many ways they tried to
obstruct
and also
destroy
the mission of Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur. But Saraswati Thakur was great devotee. They cannot destroy his mission.
They themselves were destroyed.
Yes, they themselves. And I heard their own leader, that man also famous, India famous man, big pandit. His name was Gopendu Bhushan Sankhotirtha. And when he had a meeting, one meeting call by few gentlemen in Nabadwip Dham, and that man presided in that meeting. He was president in that meeting. And he confessed that we have done wrong, and Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur done right. That meeting Guru Maharaj was only speaker.
The only speaker.
Yes. That meeting. And he was president, that Govinda Bhushan Shankaranta. And he confessed in that public meeting, what is Mahaprabhu's desire, that fulfilled by Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur, not ourselves. And we have done many wrong with him, but now we are looking, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur have done right, and his preaching was very great and truthful. This way he confessed, we heard. At that time, Guru Maharaj preached by order his Gurudev, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur, all over the India. That time India and Pakistan was same country, called Bharat. And in Pakistan, there Karachi, one capital of Pakistan, Karachi was the capital of
province.
That province. And Guru Maharaj went there to preach. And you have seen young photo of Guru Maharaj?
Yes.
With
turban.
That's taken there. And in the time of Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur, Delhi, Kurukshetra, Naimisharanya, Allahabad, Banaras, Madras, Bombay, everywhere, and also now Bangladesh, Dhaka, Kumilla, Chattogram, Guru Maharaj preached very successfully and got very hopeful response. And many of great souls came to the lotus feet of Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur that time, preaching of Guru Maharaj, the result. And Guru Maharaj never defeated in his life. And we heard, within 5 minutes, within 10 minutes, big pandit defeated by Guru Maharaj. Also, when Swami Vya is born, he went to London, went to West, London, Germany, France, etc. for preaching the conception of Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur and Krishna consciousness. And Bhanu Maharaj come back from England, but he make himself like a Western gentleman by his clothes, garments. And it was not a happy news for Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur and also other devotees. But he was very strong. That is, nobody can say anything. But in Bombay, there was Swami Maharaj, and given reception, Swami Maharaj also, to Bhanu Maharaj. And Bhanu Maharaj said, in the West, there are many questioning many things. We cannot answer that. But Guru Maharaj was there, Swami Maharaj, Guru Maharaj, and also Gosai Maharaj, and few preaching in Bombay that time, and very friendship with Swami Maharaj and Guru Maharaj. And one table, Swami Maharaj, Abhay Babu, that time, he said, what is your question? You can say?
Ask.
what questioning there in the West? And Bhagavad Maharaj said, you cannot answer that. And Srila Maharaj said, yes, can answer. And Guru Maharaj was there, and Srila Maharaj said, Srila Maharaj will answer your questions. And many questions done by Bhagavad Maharaj, Western style, and many questions. There are so many questions. And Bhagavad Maharaj gave, Srila Guru Maharaj gave one by one answer, very successfully. And lastly, Bhagavad Maharaj stopped. And Srila Maharaj told, here is Europe is defeated by Asia. This way, a joking way, he told. You are coming from Europe, and your all question is European question. And Srila Maharaj is Asian man, and he gave all answer. Then, here is, we can think, Europe is defeated by Asia. Everybody laughing. And Bhagavad Maharaj also happy to hear that. Yes, it is possible. That is, I have seen every devotee of, especially who is holding high position in the time of Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur. We can name few, Bhagavad Maharaj, Goswami Maharaj, Vasudev Prabhu, and Paramahansa Maharaj, Jajavar Maharaj, Madhav Maharaj, everybody coming to see Guru Maharaj. Here, Guru Maharaj was in a thatched house, but everybody coming and searching, where is Guru Maharaj? And they are coming here. And very happily, they are staying in this mall. 2 days, 3 days, 5 days. They have no time to stay. Also, Swami Maharaj, when coming world tour, finishing after one world tour, he is coming to see Guru Maharaj here. Maybe 3 hours, maybe one day. But he must come to see Guru Maharaj. And talking with Guru Maharaj, all news giving to Guru Maharaj, he was very happy. And also Guru Maharaj also given very enthusiasm to Srila Swami Maharaj. When Swami Maharaj first come from America, nobody wants to cooperate with him. His god brothers, he wrote letters to many big god brothers. But Guru Maharaj have no money. But they have much money. That is, he wrote to others. But they not given response. And I think, lastly he wrote to Guru Maharaj. He knows Guru Maharaj is not a rich man. And staying here very poorly, offering to Giridhari. But when Swami Maharaj wrote, Guru Maharaj very happy and said to us, you arrange Swami Maharaj coming. And he coming, successful preaching after successful preaching in the West, you arrange nicely for him. And you write letter to him, yes, we are ready to invite. Receive your holiness. And I wrote the letter. And Simon is coming here with two devotees, one Ramanuja and one Achyutananda. And very happily stayed here 7 days or 10 days maybe. I cannot remember. And given news. And we gave that time the citizens reception in Nabadwip, also Swami Sayama. And he was very happy. And that time he wrote letter to his disciple. This one, my god brother, staying in Nabadwip. I'm very high realization here, very high realization this way. I read from that Guardian of Devotion book. But I was there that time. One day happened, Swami Maharaj, we are serving Swami Maharaj some puri. I know what he is taking. Some puri, some begum bhaja, and some sweets, and some card in the table. And Swami Maharaj said, "You also take with me." And I said, "Yes, Maharaj, your order, I must carry out." And Haricharan Prabhu distributing the prasadam. But I am thinking Swami Maharaj is very great Vaishnava. I cannot take in one table with him. That is, I took my share in my hand and not in his table. I am thinking he is very great Vaishnava and I am like his servant. Then how shall I take in a table with him the prasadam? Then I took that prasadam in my hand and I am also taking, and Swami Maharaj joking me, "Why you are not taking in my table?" I said, "No, Maharaj, I am taking this." "Oh, no, I can understand. Your caste will destroy. You are Brahmin and I am coming from the West and I am taking prasadam with the sahibs, the Western devotee, and you want to keep your caste separate." Then I was very shy and I put my plate in that table and I took.
That was at the reception.
Very nice relationship was with Guru Maharaj and Swami Maharaj.
And Maharaj, you arranged that reception, is it?
Yes.
Yourself, you arranged?
Yes. A good order of Guru Maharaj. And here, some boys, favorite of our mission, we called everybody. And here in Nabadwip, so many big pandit joined in that meeting. In town hall of Nabadwip, that meeting held in town hall of Nabadwip. Bhaktivinoda Thakur forecast from the all over the world, the devotee within 50 years, devotee will come. And they will chant by the name of Mahaprabhu, Shachinandan Gaurhari, and they will chant, dance in the name of Mahaprabhu. I am looking at that. But we cannot believe at that time. We are thinking it is a forecast only. Maybe after a few hundred years, it is possible. It is possible, no doubt. The great Vaishnava wrote in his, written in his book, and must be possible, but not immediate possible. But we have seen our life, we are very fortunate, thinking within 50 years, that is very true. And Bhaktivinoda Thakur wrote maybe 50,000, I cannot remember, 50,000 devotees would come to Nabadwip, Mayapur, and they would chant the Hare Krishna Mahamantra. And this come through Srila Swami Maharaj and Srila Guru Maharaj. That is very hopeful for us. We took shelter that great devotee of Krishna. And they also very merciful to us. And all over the world now chanting Hare Krishna Mahamantra. That is, Guru Maharaj said to Swami Maharaj, it is cannot do a man. Maybe that man is very great man, but he cannot do it. It's only can do the Talunda Prabhu. And he has that power. And Swami Maharaj is Saktabesh Avatar. No doubt I have. Otherwise he was Avacharan Dev. And born in Calcutta, very simple man. And also I read Swami Maharaj's lecture. He also told, it is not my work, Mahaprabhu done through us. And it is very true. And we surprised to see the preaching. When Van Maharaj and Tirtha Maharaj and others went to the West, they cannot convert. They preach, no doubt. They cannot convert the mind and cannot properly distribute it, the Krishna consciousness. It is very true. Maybe not hearing sweet it, but it is very true. But when we have seen the Western devotees coming with tilaka, with mala and shikha, and also saffron clothes like an Indian saint, they are coming and dancing by the name of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and chanting Hare Krishna Mahamantra and maintaining the spiritual life very hardly. Then we are surprised and very glad to see that. When Jayatirtha Maharaj came here with 150 devotees in this mart, and we have no rooms here. They are sleeping under the tree. They are sleeping under that ground. And that only blue house, they are not accommodation possible, was possible. But devotees do not care that. In the Gaur Purnima time also, here, if full devotee will come, then no accommodation is possible to give them. But they are not mind anything. They are very happy to stay here. I have seen in the Tulasi, their mancho, devotee sleeping there, sleeping in open roof. That is, I am also very affectionate with all. And I am thinking it is my very good fortune. Yeah, I have got the association of the devotees like that. And it was possible by the preaching of Srila Swami Maharaj and Srila Guru Maharaj. Swami Maharaj confessed, he was very great. And he himself confessed, yes, Sridhar Maharaj, Srila Sridhar Maharaj is my Shikha Guru. I consider him my Shikha Guru. And Prabhupada and Krishna sent him to prepare me, Swami Maharaj told. In this meeting here, one chair, we are worshipping Guru Maharaj's butt, the ceremony to Guru Maharaj, and his godbrothers also, Siddhanti Maharaj, Mosul Maharaj, every godbrother who like Guru Maharaj and who have time in hand, he is coming that time. And also that year, Srila Swami Maharaj also came here. And he gave that lecture, and that is printed, I am sure. Then, Swami, I think Srila Swami Maharaj in his whole his learning in life, learning of Shastra and Krishna consciousness, that life he spent with Guru Maharaj. He three or four times I've seen Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur. He took diksha from Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur, but not got association. But he got association of Guru Maharaj, and he took Guru Maharaj in his house for that. And every day we are looking, when Guru Maharaj is going from Nabadwip to Calcutta, he's staying there. And every day Swami Maharaj is coming morning 8 o'clock or 9 o'clock to see Guru Maharaj and discussing many things. And also Shastra, Vedanta, Upanishad, Srimad Bhagavad-gita, everything, discussing. And very heavy discussions going up to 2 o'clock some day. And we are very hungry, we cannot stay. And lastly, we are telling to Guru Maharaj, Maharaj, we cannot tolerate, please stop it. These are many things gone. And that is last time when the devotee asked to Srila Swami Maharaj, what is your last desire? Please tell us. We shall try to fulfill your desire, last desire. Swami Maharaj wants to leave this mundane world. That time devotees asked to him. And Swami Maharaj said, yes, Krishna says everything is okay. I have no special any desire. But they insist, nothing you have. Then they said, Swami Maharaj said, yes, two things I can tell you. One, this Nath Mandir of Srila Guru Maharaj, Sridhar Maharaj. This Nath Mandir, you know Nath Mandir? This front of the temple, this building. It not was completed. And Srila Sai Maharaj said, if you can complete the Sridhar Maharaj's Nath Mandir, I shall be very happy. And other one, if you can make one Nath Mandir in front of Mahaprabhu's temple, Mayapur, their Jogpit temple, in front, no Nath Mandir there. If you can make their own Nath Mandir, I shall be very happy. And Guru and Gauranga, he remembered last time. I am thinking. And he's gone, his devotee came here, and they finished it this time by their money. Srila Swami Maharaj told to Guru Maharaj, I am bringing the raw materials from the West. Boys and girls I am bringing from the West. They do not know what is Krishna conception and what is the etiquette of Vaishnavism. But they are coming, attracted by Srimad Mahaprabhu's conception. To me, they are coming. And I am offering to you, you correct them. And you make them for Mahaprabhu. Sometimes he said, I have that tape, but that tape recorder is bad. Pulling system.
Spool system.
That tape. Big. Step with me, but few, only two, three. I was poor that time. Now I am a rich man. At that time I was very poor. And one step I am using for everybody.
That was the problem. That's value was 36 rupees, 50 rupees, and I did not want to spend for that. Very costly. Otherwise, if I think that it will be worthful in future, then I can take many trips. But I have not done this that time. And also so many letters from Swami Maharaj I have got time to time. And I not kept that. A few letters, 4-5 letters with me, and very heavy letter also. And 1, 2, 3 letters sufficient for all devotees. Suddenly that letter with him, his own handwriting in Bengali, and very hopeful for all the devotees, that letter. I have done few copies, Xerox copies, in Bengali letters. There Swami Maharaj is mentioning, yeah, I am preaching in the West, my health is not good. You Govinda Maharaj, I do not want to disturb your Guru Maharaj Srila Siddhar Swami. I am asking you, you tell your Guru Maharaj, if I die suddenly here, what will be for myself? I want to die in Vrindavan. But here is so many work, seva, for myself, waiting. I shall preach here or I shall go to Vrindavan. You ask your Guru Maharaj and quick answer me. One letter. And I told Srila Guru Maharaj this letter, that letter with me. I told Srila Guru Maharaj, Swami Maharaj's question is that. And Guru Maharaj said, so where is Swami Maharaj living? There is Vrindavan Guru. There, Vrindavan, he is always living in Vrindavan. Then no fearful for that. He may die anywhere, Vrindavan is there. You go. You write that answer. And I wrote that answer. That letter also is Sudhir Goswami. He collected. He said 1 year ago to me, yes, that letter also. My answer. And again Swami Maharaj gave one letter. That also is here. Yes, I have got permission from my Guru. I shall stay here and I shall preach here. Very nice, nice letter, but I not kept that. Now I am thinking I am very foolish. It was necessary to keep him quiet. This day, it must be worthful for the devotee, the mind.
Valuable.
Valuable. Only 4-5 letters. And also one letter given by one Maharaj to Guru Maharaj. That Mayapur Management Committee now giving many commandments. But if they will see that letter, they must will stop their preaching. That letter given one Maharaj to Guru Maharaj. But that also I not get. Maybe five. So many things happen. And happening in our life. But we are still trying to practice our Krishna consciousness. Under guidance of Srila Guru Maharaj. We are chanting Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, but we cannot chant properly. If we can chant properly, then a result we can see, no doubt. That is, offenses is the cause. Without offense, chanting the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra is very difficult. Ego in our life, great obstruction for that. Ego is very bad. That ego coming from ego. Yeah, I am this, I am that, I am great, I am small, I am father, I am mother, I am son. This type, all the ego coming from the illusion, and that is the obstruction. Vaishnava chini dinare devet shakoti. In the scripture said it, je nobody can recognize the Vaishnava. Who is Vaishnava and who is non-Vaishnava? Mostly cannot recognize. And that is the problem for liberated society.
Conditioned soul.
That is the very problem. Then very grand way Krishna consciousness given us by our Guru, that is service to the Vaishnava, service to the Lord, service to the Guru. Through this service, we may be clean, and we must clean ourselves through service. And that service, when we'll take form of transcendental, that is our action. I heard from Swami Maharaj, when the joining the devotee, he is giving 5 rules and regulations to them. They don't take intoxication, don't do this, don't do that. And 5 in Srimad Bhagavatam, 4. There is 5, but Sarma has given restriction 4. And 1, that is money, not given restriction. And he kept for himself that. It is a very nice thing. He took the charge himself. He told the devotee, you collect money anyhow and give me. And I shall use for Mahaprabhu, then no harmful for yourself. And one day I heard from Guru Maharaj also, that was very sweet and very strong. One devotee, great devotee of Srila Guru Maharaj, he bought some money, maybe 18,000 rupees. And he given Guru Maharaj that money. And Guru Maharaj was happy, and he also very happy. Guru Maharaj took his money, and Guru Maharaj asking many things, news of other devotees. Then that devotee asked to Guru Maharaj, Maharaj, what you will do with this money? What seva you will do with this money? He is asking to Guru Maharaj. And Guru Maharaj immediate take turn and take position. And Guru Maharaj said, that is not your business. Guru Maharaj was very happy and talking with the devotee, with that devotee. And he is searching, that devotee what is doing, that devotee what is doing. And like this very happy mood, they are talking. And that devotee was very enthusiastic. And he gave much money to Guru Maharaj. And happily he asked him to Guru Maharaj, Maharaj, what seva will you do with this money? And Guru Maharaj immediately took charge.
Change.
And said, that is not your duty. That is my duty. Your duty is finished. You collected and given me, that is finished. But what is Krishna consciousness? Necessary to know that. Fully surrendered to Guru. And through Guru, he will got everything. What conception will be given by Guru, that is enough for him. And Krishna may sometimes angry with the devotee, but that not fearful for the devotee. That is middle point, Guru is there. And Guru can manage everything. Krishna may be unhappy with him, but if he is pretty of his Guru, pretty?
Favored by his Guru.
By his Guru, then no problem for him. He must manage. But if Guru is angry, then Krishna cannot give shelter. In Bengali phrase, very nice there. Yeah. Krishna rushto hole guru rakhi bale pare. Guru rushto hole Krishna rakhi bale nare. When Krishna is angry, then Guru can give shelter and can modify. But when Guru is angry, then Krishna not will give shelter and not will do what. This is Bengali phrase. Mane, where my all auspiciousness coming? From where?
From where?
That is position of Guru. And all auspiciousness coming through Guru. And I wrote one sloka about Guru Maharaj, not one, 10 or 12, maybe one time, so long ago. Stop, Guru Maharaj is stop. There I started this word, bhagyadhisho. Bhagyadhisho tadiyo vimalasukamayo samprakashastumitto. This way, that Sanskrit poetry. I use first word, the Bhagyadhisho. In the Jyotish Shastra, 9th house is fortune house. If you know the Jyotish Shastra, you can understand. In 9th house, 12th house, but now 9th house is specified for fortune. Yeah? Specifically for fortune. And that house holder is Brihaspati. And Brihaspati is Devaguru. Then, 9th house we can say the Guru's house. And this way, meaning is going two way. You were my 9th house holder. Also, you are my fortune maker. This two way, the meaning will go. My fortune depending upon my Guru. If Guru is good, Guru is great, then I have no fear from anywhere. And my faith, we are living in the plane of faith. Guru Maharaj said, faithful plane, plane of faith. We are living in the plane of faith. And that is necessary. the plane of faith, no other way. Not only the Vaishnavism, not only this religion, Vaishnava religion, but it is very true. Every religion saying that. Faith in Mohammedanism, Buddhism, in Christianism, many ism in this world, but they are every higher, first place getting faith. Christianism and Vaishnavism, very behavior is very near. They are Jesus, what teach Jesus for the Jiva soul, that motive of the Jiva soul, always very humble and do not disturb to others, and faithfully you go to your destiny without offense. And Vaishnavism also telling that. And I read 3 days ago also, and before also I read Quran. And Mohammedanism also like that. But different, destiny is different, no doubt. Somebody going to Calcutta, somebody going to Delhi, somebody going to London. That is, place is different. But going mood is almost very near to same. If you want to do anything good, then you must be make yourself a very humble person first. Otherwise cannot do anything. If everybody will give some obstruction, not obstruction, badha.
Protection.
That everybody will give some
objection.
Objection or obstruction. Then you, obstruction is good, what I think. Then you cannot do anything. Then you first collect this qualification, that is humility and humble. Mahaprabhu said very clearly, Jatinadupi Shumicheno, Tarorivo Shaishuna, Omanina Manadeno Kirtaniya Sadhana. Who can chant properly the Hare Krishna Mahamantra? And who is qualified this way? Very humble. And who can tolerate everything? Tolerating mood. We are always doing wrong, no doubt, in this mandate. But necessary to tolerate and correct that. And also, who have no position or respect, that type man or jiva soul, we must give some honor. Then everybody will be happy. And I not any obstruction, I shall not got any obstruction from others. And also my mind also peaceful always with all. Alap deva vinasteva bhakkha chadana sadhane abhiklava mati bhutta harime vadhyasaya. In the scripture, everywhere telling you first qualification. You are getting or not getting. You are getting or losing. Alabdheva vinashteva. That is, maybe your food or maybe your clothes or your mental position or anything. But you must keep quiet your mind and stay in the faithful plane and try to practice Krishna consciousness very humbly. This is the Vaishnavism, very simple way we can say it. But newcomer, they sometimes confuse to looking many things. And our duty, we must help them all with our behavior, with our affection, with our motive. We must try to help everybody. Srila Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur said, what is good, making a big hospital or rescue one conditioned soul from the illusion? What is best? And he gave answer, in making many hospitals, we can disturb the universe. But if we can rescue one jiva soul from the illusion of Maya, that is the best seva of jiva soul. In a hospital, they are also doing seva, service. But that is not proper seva. One dacoit, he is shooted by police and he gone to hospital. And he cured. Maybe 15 days or 1 month he put in jail. And when after coming back from the jail, he is doing again dacoit. And there is no goodness. My seva for that dacoit, not proper seva. I have done seva of that man and cured that man. That is good, but I cannot change his mind. That is very bad. Then after getting strength, that man again will do that wrong work, bad. Then Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur said, many hospitals doing not necessary. Only if we can try to rescue one jiva soul from this illusion, that is very valuable seva of the jiva soul. And that seva, Mahaprabhu advised to his devotees. Jive daya, name ruchi, Vaishnava seva. Three, you must serve the jiva soul this way. Preach their Krishna consciousness, turn his illusion mind, and take them for the service of Krishna, service to the Krishna. This is jivedaya, kindness to the jiva soul, real kindness, and name ruchi, and chant Hare Krishna Mahamantra without offenses, and Vaishnava seva. A three instructions, simply three instructions. Vaishnava seva means who is 24 hours servicing the Lord and his associates and his devotees. He is Vaishnava. And you serve him. Then you have no problem. Yesterday I told in the jungle, one man can chant Hare Krishna Mahamantra, but that chanting is not proper chanting. Better than chanting is service to the Vaishnavas. That is the better. It is clear?
Yes.
My English is very poor. I do not speak English, but now necessity is the mother of invention. English coming gradually, literally too, for the devotee. I am not feeling very problem now. My devotee is very merciful to me. And I am telling something wrong sometimes. But they are correcting himself, my English, and taking good way. Then I have no problem now. And Guru Maharaj, he is very merciful. He mercifully gave the association of the devotees. And we are tied together, properly chant Hare Krishna Mahamantra all over the world. No problem we have. And mundane problem must will come to us and give us some trouble. And we know that, then we have no problem. We can stay everywhere. We can stay in a building or in a thatched house or can go everywhere. That is means of Krishna and my karma. But if we engage ourselves to service, service of Guru Vaishnava, Bhagavan, then we have no problem. You read the books, Sarva Sri Krishna maybe, or some English book printed from, there also printed the story. Yeah. Yudhishthira Maharaj done one big Ashwamedh yajna, Rajushri yajna. But there, Krishna told, when yajna will be finished, that ring bell,
will ring
automatically. But yajna already finished, but not ringing that bell. And Bhimsena asking to Krishna, what is this? You told, now finish all. And Krishna said, oh, not fulfill it. I said, what fault you say? We shall try to manage. We shall try to make up that. And Krishna said, yes, many rishi, muni, big personality came here to take your puja. And they are all happy, but had a real Vaishnava not come in your festival, then Yudhishthira said to Krishna, yourself, you are present here, then everything must be fulfilled. Why not fulfill it? Krishna said, yes, not. Shalo hridayam madhyam sadhunan hridayam taham madannatte no jananti naham te bhumanagati. My heart thiefed by the devotee. Then I am here not fully. My devotee took my heart and they are living outside from your festival place. And where is that devotee? Oh, he is living there. You go there and bring him and worship him, give food, nursing, good nursing. Then if he will be happy, then everything will be finished properly. And Bhimsena immediately gone. Raja Yudhishthira worship him and Draupadi, she make many things for that devotee. But devotee is very shy and unhappy to come the king's house. But when king calls, must will go. He come and they not said,
Good hospitality
they gave. And Draupadi herself cooked for that devotee. And many things, many ways she cooked and offered to the devotee, and very shyly devotee taking something. And devotee all the curry preparation mixed in one plate, and he took and gone away, but not ringing bell. And very difficulty, Yudhishthira asking to Krishna, what happened? Not ringing the bell. Then Krishna said, must be something fault is here. And what fault? Anything? Offense? Done any offense to him? Krishna said, must. Somebody done must offense to him. And asking five brothers and Subhadra, what you think when that devotee comes to hear? Oh no, we have not done any offense. Yudhishthira, Bhima, Arjuna, Nakula, Sahadeva, everybody said, we have not done any offense. Then Krishna asked to Draupadi, in your mind anything when that devotee come and took prasadam? And Draupadi said, yes, in my mind I cooked very
nicely
everything and many
preparation separate.
And he took all mixing. And that is, I think, he is not many culture. He do not know what is what. My mind was this, oh, this is the offense to the Vaishnava. Then what will do? Again you call him and give nice food to him and worship him. And again done this. And when he is taking, and Draupadi is very fearful and she is seated, folded hand and thinking no aparad, no offense will come. And that man come and taking one glass. That is?
One handful.
One handful, two, three, and ringing. Dong, dong. What is seva? That necessary to know. We may can do anything, but that not may be seva. And that is the problem. And then offense is very bad thing. And without offense, doing something is very difficulty. Then Vaishnava always careful from the offenses. That is my final advice to all of the scriptures. Satang ninda namna paramam aparadham vitante. Paramam aparadham, mane super offense is don't abuse the devotee. Abuse, ninda. Satang ninda. Mane where my all auspiciousness coming through higher, if I shall put there one obstruction, my ego, then auspicious cannot come to me. And my road, that road, auspicious road, floor must be checked. And everything is living thing. What we are looking, what we are saying, what we are doing, everything is living. Jivan in Bengali. Then I can see the tree cannot move. But when we have seen, here was one another tree you have seen. You have also seen there was another tree. And Guru Maharaj, he disappeared and we took there to Guru Maharaj in Tulasi Tala, the Tulsi Maharani there, and we took Guru Maharaj there. And after finishing this samadhi of Guru Maharaj, we are looking that trees, leaves falling down. And within 1 day or 2 days, all the leaves fall down. And that tree immediate died, dead. And I was very sad. I am very, associated with the trees or everything here of this mark. I am very sad, why this tree gone? He has much love for Guru Maharaj, that is, he cannot tolerate disappearance of Guru Maharaj. And he gone. But after 8 months or 6 months, after 6 months, when we started the Samadhi Mandir of Guru Maharaj, then I can understand why that tree gone. There is two cause. He cannot tolerate disappearance of Guru Maharaj. And other thing, if he not will disappear, I shall not cut that tree. It is very true.
For me, in Samadhi Mandir.
And Samadhi Mandir not will come this way. If we have eyes, we can see. I must change the plan of Samadhi Mandir. But it is not happening with my plan. Everything is transcendental. We are telling, we are reading, we are hearing. Yeah, everything is transcendental. Then Samadhi also transcendental. And it is there, now manifesting himself, the Samadhi Mandir. If that tree not gone, then this way Samadhi Mandir making not was possible. And it is there, that is immediate Hare Krishna. Jai Om Vishnu Maharaj Srila Bhakti Rakhat Siddhantiv Goswami Maharaj Ki Jai.
Jai
Om
Vishnu Maharaj Srila Bhakti Sangha.
He is coming from Hapaniya Mott. He is in church there now and doing very nice seva. Birthplace of Srila Guru Maharaj, there we make one temple. Going seva nicely there. He comes from there. This garden is Gopinath's garden. I am looking at Guru Maharaj's garden. Guru Maharaj in the and tell you what, he is giving us illustration. I have no doubt. When I am in little disturbed position, then Guru Maharaj is coming in front. That time I am going front, Guru Maharaj is pushing me back. In my back. He is pushing me and I am going in front. Now I am looking, Guru Maharaj is in my front. And I am going, I am following him. Then I am more safe this way. In this time, middle time, many things happen. Maybe all over the world many things happen. And here also many things happen. But all darkness gradually gone. Something gone quickly, something gone gradually. This way everything setting, going set right. No problem. But great personality, transcendental personality, when left this mundane world, then some disturbance must come. And I told from the first time, you must be careful for disturbing. And we have seen, and fully when we are surrendered to Guru Maharaj and wants a help from the upper level, and if we can pray properly, must help will come to us. I have no doubt, I am looking. You say, somebody will explain why that tree gone disappear, his own way. But who can look it? Must will think, why this tree gone? And if open eye we can see, we can try to see that, we must can see. And now I have no doubt. I am looking this cause that tree disappeared. And there is temple, but it was hidden, now manifested. I am not an engineer, I am not qualified. But how coming this nice temple, coming out in our front, and gradually coming out. I am not so given attention for the temple. A little instruction I am giving, they do this, do this, they do that. But they are making, I am not making it. But it is coming out. I am going to Calcutta, going to Puri, going to Hapaniyan. It is gradually coming out and nicely. And what is there, that is coming out. If we can see this way, everything, we have no problem. When Srivas Pandit, in his house, Mahaprabhu himself chanting with his devotees, with his associates. That very day Srivas Pandit's sons disappear. It is unthinkable matter. Mahaprabhu is dancing, chanting in the house of Srivas Pandit, and he is present there, but his son dead. And Srivas Pandit not telling to Mahaprabhu anything. And his wife, Malini Devi, crying, but very hiddenly crying. They do not want to disturb the dancing and chanting of Mahaprabhu's Krishna Nam. They do not want to disturb that. But Mahaprabhu knows everything. And he told, I am not feeling good today. What happened in this house? And Srivas Pandit, oh, nothing, Prabhu. You chant and dance, nothing. Oh, no, no, I am not feeling good. What happened? Tell. Then he told, Srivas Pandit told to Mahaprabhu, one soul, jiva soul, mercifully come to my house and bury. Today he is disappeared. And Mahaprabhu very busily gone there and gave some santana. Santana in this
pacification. Pacification.
Gave some pacification to the ladies and to others. And he called that boy. Say, you boy, you are leaving us today. Why you are leaving? We are here chanting, dancing, and you are leaving. It is not looking good. Why you are doing that?
Already he has left.
Yes. The dead body. And Mahaprabhu asked to dead body, he lived. Why? Then dead body talking. Everything as meant, made. We cannot see that. And what said that dead body, that is the truth. I have very good fortune, that is, I born in Sivash Pandit's house, and now I am going to making my seva for your divine holiness, divine grace. And I was very fortunate. This way, he told. And one day, if anybody will born, he must will die other day. That is not a lookable matter. It is happening every day.
Ahannani bhutani gacchanti jama mandiram shetha astirattam icchanti kimarchar jamatapam. Every day, the dying, the jiva souls, changing his body. It is not very
remarkable.
Ashchurja mane surprise matter. Mm-hmm. It is not very surprise matter, but matter is surprise that everybody thinking I shall live long. That is surprise matter. Everybody dying every day, that is not surprise.
Astonishing. Astonishing. Not astonishing.
Not astonishing. But everybody thinking, I shall not die. I maybe die other day. That is, thinking is very surprising. This way, this world is going. And with full consciousness and mercy, we can see everything. It is very true. We know what not known. That is not problem. But what happening, that must be happening.
Jaya Om Vishwa Atman Jubai Braj Gajar Jubaja Sosasya Srimad Bhakti Lopak Sreda Dev Goswami Maharaj Ki
Jaya
Gauranga Gandharva Govinda Sundar Jiv Ki
Jaya
Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Sarasya Goswami Prabhupad Ki
Jaya
Ananta Kati Vashtambinda Ki Jaya Shabhata Siman Mahaprabhu Ki Jaya Srupanuga Guru Bhattu Ki Jaya Abhinam Sankirtan Ki Jaya Swami Vashtamandali Ki Jaya Vashtambinda Ki Jaya Bhaktivinda Ki Jaya Om Prabhanande
Hare
Okay, I am very happy to see you here, and you stay happily.
Yes.
But management is not maybe suitable for the Western devotee, but their heart is very sweet. Then they can manage everything and adjust with them. But try to adjust with proper food. It is my request. I do not know what is suitable for the Western body. In Indian body can tolerate many things. Mustard oil, many things they are taking, and many sabji they are taking. This way, you order to the mod command here, and they will serve, try to serve you. Especially, if you need anything, you can see Mahananda Prabhu. He is in charge now. Yeah. He shall be very happy to hear your happiness.
see.